This is the worst tile job I've seen, honestly. Welcome to Tile Coach. I'm Isaac Ostrom. I'm a tile contractor from Northern California. Today I'm here with Roger, who had some problems with the install of his shower. Okay, so Roger had sent me a text message with some pictures, and to be honest, when I first saw the pictures, you know, they were from far, far back, and I could just see this wall in the shower. And first impression was, oh, it doesn't look that bad. But when I walked in the room, it was real easy to tell that this job was pretty rough. I mean, this is one of the worst tile jobs I've seen in a shower, and I've seen a lot of them. So I came in and I saw right off the bat stuff like this. So this is a Schluter profile. They actually used a PVC Schluter profile. This is the PRO100 in the bright white finish. So it's PVC plastic. That's fine to use. We don't use it. But you can see he put the corners in wrong. He had them flipped. And there's actually one right here. So this corner is an example of, you know, look, he had this corner in. That's not how they go. This is an inside corner that he tried to put as an outside corner. So it should have looked like that, and it looked like that. So yeah, the Schluter's installed wrong. There's some nicks, like here's a nick in the Schluter that got caught with the saw blade or whatever he used to cut it. He just left it. A lot of lippage in here. Now, lippage is when one tile is sticking out past the other, that the tiles aren't flat. I see a lot of lippage in here. Really rough cuts. It looks like he used a grinder for a lot of his cuts. He used a dry cutter, and he might have used the dry cutter on all of this. Or he might have had a combination of a snap cutter, which a snap cutter will do straight lines, but you can't do the L cut, so he probably used a 4-inch grinder on that. And yeah, just an overall really sloppy job. I'm gonna get into it because right over here, there is, and as Jeremy stepped on that, you could hear it. Something going on there. But these tiles right off the bat, there's a lot of lippage here, but this gap here between the tile and the curdy board, we probably have, that's probably a solid half inch. So it's okay to build your thin set out a half inch, but there's hollow spaces in here. And what I'm assuming he did was kind of like a dot set. In a shower, you need to have 95% coverage for a wet area. What that means is you want full amount of mortar between the tile and the wall board. Otherwise, you're creating pockets where water vapor will get in and water, and it has nowhere to go, so it starts to mold. And then that's when you get the water damage too, when it starts to seep out. So I assume these are dot set because I can actually push on these tiles. And you can hear that. You can push on these tiles. And this whole wall sounds hollow. So I'm gonna pull one of these tiles just to see what went on there. You know, there's a lot of build out in here, and you know, to be fair to the installer too, and this is one thing that I never do. I never install tile on someone else's prep work. And I do get inquiries about that. I get people who watch my videos, they say, I'm gonna do the demo, I'm gonna do the waterproofing, and then I just need somebody to come in and set the tile. I say, no. The prep work has to be done by us because you're relying on someone else to get it ready. And so the homeowner, Roger, did the prep work with the curdy board and the curdy system, and the tile guy just set the tile. So I don't know, Roger might not have been able to straighten out the walls very well, but it was probably just a combination of the two things, bad prep job, bad tile installer, and it compounded itself to create like one of the worst showers I've seen. So we're gonna take a few tiles apart. There is something here also that the installer did, And here's some penny tiles where there's no coverage. So actually, look at this. There's literally no thin set under those penny tiles. As I pull these out, I'm just pulling these out with my fingers because they're not adhered. Oh, and you know what else? Here's another thing that wasn't done correctly. Okay, so Schluter, this is a foam pan. I can tell this is a foam pan by how much give when I push on it. So with a Schluter foam pan or any other type of pan, you cannot set a tile that's under 2 inches by 2 inches square. So these penny tiles are too small, meaning if you were to put direct point load onto one of these tiles, it's gonna smash down into the foam. So you need a bigger tile to distribute that point load so that it won't go into the foam pan. Because I can take my finger and push down on the tiles, and it's pushing all the way down into that foam because the foam is so soft. That's one of the reasons why we always float our pans. We don't have to deal with that. So that was done wrong. And I don't know why he didn't get coverage. Real messy with some of the areas. I mean, he's got thin set packed all through this, just so sloppy. This would have been really hard to try to clean up and grout. I mean, almost impossible. I don't know how. All of this would have had to be scraped out just to grout it. So you would have had probably days of cleanup just so that this would be able to be grouted. Hey, what a mess. This is the worst tile job I've seen, honestly. And I'm sure there's worse. I'm sure there's worse out there. But this is the worst tiled shower that I've seen. Okay, so here's a Schluter drain. And the way these are supposed to work is this ring snaps in. So this ring snaps in like this. And this part is supposed to snap into the collar, and it's supposed to go down. He just brought his tile, hung it over, and you can't even get this in here. So all these tiles would need to be pulled off and redone. There's no way to get that in. So he had no experience with Schluter. Obviously never done one of these drains. So I'm gonna just pop a couple tiles. It's pretty evident though that this whole thing needs to come out, and I'll be kind of breaking the news to the homeowner. And what I usually do is offer them a price for our company to do it. And if they do it and it's in their budget, great. If not, at least they have some knowledge when they go and find another contractor. So I don't charge for these initial consultations. Okay, so I'm gonna just check and see what's going on behind the tile. It's pretty obvious. Like this tile, I probably don't even need a hammer. I could probably just take it out. But let's see if I had something. Oh, I'm just gonna make it easy on myself and just break a little corner of it off. So yeah, so you see right there, there's no coverage. No coverage at all behind that tile. So let's see what he did here. Okay. So that's his coverage. See how clean the curdy board is. And I think they used an off-brand of the seam tape, which isn't a problem, but that's definitely a problem. You have some coverage right here, a little bit right here, and a little bit right there. Mold, you know, this will just end up getting water and just get nasty. So that's a problem. So yeah, one tile, I probably don't need to take any more off because they're kind of all like that, I can tell. So there's another tile. So using a notch trowel is just pointless because it didn't do anything. They could have just put their little dollops on here. I don't know. I don't think it's worth trying to save the curdy board. I mean, but it could. I mean, if all the tiles came off like that. But I wouldn't guarantee the work. I would have to strip it all down and go in with new. So that's what I'm gonna suggest. But the homeowner might wanna try to pluck all these tiles off, but I don't think you would be able to do this with the floor. I'm trying to take all of these guys off and save the foam. It wouldn't be a good idea. So there you have it. Basically, this whole shower needs to come out and be redone. I wouldn't guarantee the work on it if to try to do a repair. It's just the whole thing is so bad that it just needs to come out. But luckily the homeowner caught it and addressed it before it got too far, it was grouted and there was more work done. And probably this is like the best case scenario, because again, these situations can get ugly, especially if you get someone, a contractor who's angry, who's maybe has other issues, because there's crazy people out there. I'm sure you believe me, but this goes to show also, you need to trust the referrals that you're getting. The Nextdoor app, I know nothing about it. I don't have it on my phone, but I'll probably download it just so I can learn a little bit more about it, because I have heard here and there of people finding contractors as a referral source on this Nextdoor neighbor app. But goes to show, even if they have some recommendations, you really need to do your homework. And I would suggest seeing some of their work in person, because pictures can be deceiving. I would also talk directly to people that they've done work for, because again, a picture, it can be very misleading. And as a rule of thumb, here in California, use a licensed contractor. That means they've gone through the proper steps and training to be legit. So unfortunately, Roger had to find out the hard way. Hopefully the contractor, I hope you actually end up seeing this video and maybe watch some more of my videos so you can get better at what you do, because obviously you have a passion for doing this type of work or you wouldn't be doing it. And my hope is for you that you learn from this mistake and you really start digging into learning how to do it better. And preferably, I would say, don't try to do another project like this on your own. Go have somebody mentor for you. Go be an apprentice. Go work with them for a year or two. And then come back and start doing these type of jobs. So I hope this video helped both the person who did it and others out there. I hope if you're a homeowner, this helped to educate you on how to find proper contractors and what to do if you get into these situations. So I hope you found this video educational, informational, and entertaining at the same time. I love making these videos. I'm so glad Roger reached out. And if you run into something like this, shoot me an email, leave your comments in the section below, and maybe I can come out and do this at your house too. So anyways, I love you guys. I love being your tile coach. Watch the next videos coming up, and we'll see you on the next video.